Danko doesn't just talk about focus, he lives it.
This guy Dan, he writes for 30 minutes every morning. Oh, that seems so boring. But it's mastery over misery.
Danko is a creator, writer, and thinker whose work blends systems, philosophy, and software. With over 1 million YouTube subscribers and over 4 million in yearly revenue, he's also the co-founder of Cortex, a second brain app. I sat down with Dan to unpack his routines, his tech stack, and how AI and philosophy are being blended together.
Productivity and self-help advice is useful, but it's abundant.
So Dan, I wanted to ask where it all began for you. Why philosophy?
During college, I started to dive more into spirituality, and that led to more philosophy. And I've always kind of been interested in big ideas. And so that required me to not only read about those things and study them and learn them, but to also put them into practice and make them a consistent and routine part of my life to see if they actually held their weight.
So I'm really curious about what your daily routine looks like, a typical day in the life of Dan with that sort of mindful element in place.
I'll wake up, I'll take the dog out, I'll drink my water electrolytes, and then I'll go take a shower, get ready, go make coffee, sit down, and then start writing. And now when I say writing, that's usually like, for me, that's the lever moving tasks for my personal business and technically Cortex, the software business, because I'm the main distribution mechanism for that. That's what I kind of bring to the company. That's right? The most important thing that I can do is just make sure that good content is out on all platforms, short form platforms, a portion of the newsletter, and the newsletter is what gets turned into a YouTube script and podcast. After that, I will tend to record something. It's usually like 10 or 11 o'clock, and then I'll go on a walk, I'll eat lunch, I'll go to the gym. So like a midday stretch where I'm not working, and I'll usually like respond on Slack. If I have to catch up on messages or do administrative work, that's usually when that happens. Other things tend to catch my attention. I'll add stuff to the newsletter. I'll jot things down here and there, but I'm not really trying to get into any specific intensive task at that point. And then around 5, I'll go get dinner or make dinner or order dinner in. And then at that point, I'm kind of offline. So nothing that can throw me off or distract me in the morning. Get straight into work, do that work for 3 hours. And then after that, once I go on a walk, get lunch, go to the gym, that's kind of like the break where all the high entropy stuff that could throw me for a loop happens then. So checking Slack, putting out fires, all that stuff.
So in terms of your tool stack, what does it look like for you in terms of everyday tools for you as an individual and as a company?
Yeah. I like using Boostcamp for fitness stuff. So when I used to have my workouts in Apple Notes before, what I would do is I just have the workout written down. And then every week I'd just like, okay, I know what I did last week. Let's see if I can go higher than that. Okay, I went higher than that. Let me change that number. So it wasn't like a continuing long list every week. It was just one workout plan. And then I changed the weight and reps that I did every week. And that helped, but you can't see like the visual progression every 12 weeks, every however so often. So that one's fun, especially if you don't know what workout to do in the gym. Tightfully for Twitter scheduling and Thread scheduling. I feel like they're the only ones that allow you to schedule posts on the Threads platform by Instagram. I'll write all my stuff in Cortex, but then I'll copy paste it over into Tightfully, and then that will schedule the same piece of content to go out on X, on Threads, sometimes LinkedIn, but sometimes I like to do something different for LinkedIn. For LinkedIn or Instagram, I use Figma to kind of create the images with the text on them that are pretty much my tweets, but pasted into a little design that I have in Figma. A journey for image generation. It's just a classic. I like to, whenever I don't need to design like an icon or something where I have a specific idea of what I want for it, I'll put it into Midjourney and I can usually get something quite well. I feel like agents aren't really there yet on a lot of the things in my workflow, at least. For the knowledge work stuff, like meeting notes and other things, like I have a meeting note taker granola, which is just like a very popular meeting note taker. And that's awesome. I love that because you just get everything that was in the meeting and just sent to Slack or to your email right after. Really cool. Calendar app, just the calendar that's on Mac. Yeah, I also feel like the systems, the frameworks, the apps, the Notion templates, the Obsidian workflows, all of those things, they're very helpful to get you started with something. But then you always encounter the problem with Notion or sometimes Obsidian. You log in one day and you're like, this is a mess. Like, I can't even find anything anymore. It feels clunky. Like, I'm trying to do one thing, but I have to go through all of these steps in order to get there. And so it's useful to get people into the habit, but eventually that system may become like outdated for them. But once you know all of the principles, once you know what you're doing, and you have that solid sense of intuition because you've done it for long enough, you don't really need those anymore, because the system at that point is just a habit for you. So it's like a habit that you do every day, and you don't really need to check whether or not it's in a good UI.
So what we've learned here from Dan Stack is more about his intention of focus, especially in his routine, using that morning element to really drill down on the most important thing to him, which is writing. And also looking at his stack, he's not overloading it with tools that aren't necessarily useful. He's picking ones that help him to optimize his day, all the way from granola to the other applications like Cortex and Typefully for his system. So I would like to say a big, big thank you for stopping by. This is a brand new series called Stacks. If you'd like to take part as a stack, then feel free to submit your entry below. You can also join Stacks Premium, which dives into over 100 tool stacks, as well as guides, software perks, and much, much more. You can find that linked below if you're interested. But if you're interested in more stacks like this, then do subscribe, like this video, and share it with someone you think will help. So thank you very much. I look forward to reading your comments below, as this is the first episode and a bit of a change of content direction. So I will see you around. And a big thank you to Dan for coming here on the channel.